Hey, what's going on? Welcome back to Screen Sanctum. It's Steve. Today I'm going to react to episode 3 of Community entitled Introduction to Film. So, if you've been with me for the last couple of weeks, every Monday I post my reaction. I did episode 1 2 weeks ago, episode 2 this past Monday, and I enjoyed them both. A lot of you have been commenting, and you could tell I'm really enjoying it more and more as the episodes progress, which you all have told me is going to happen. So I'm looking forward to episode 3, and I'm looking forward into getting deeper into season 1. But this is where I am now, so let me start recording and get to this. So let's hit play.
I heard this class was a cakewalk. Are you passing it?
Death.
Oh, he's funny.
So called is a thing that makes men weep. Open your textbooks to page.
Look at him. He looks more comfortable now. Got a little long.
Now, close them and throw them away.
I actually had a professor like this in college. I did have a teacher like this.
No papers. You want an A? Live in the moment.
Perfect class for him.
Take off your shoes. This day could be your last. You could die in your sleep.
Oh my God.
You could get hit by a bus. You, that mole is raised and dark. It's not a good combo. But I'll be old too soon. Carpe diem.
Looks like he's older than the teacher.
I like it.
Boys, <come. laughs>
would you please use the buttons?
Okay, Grandpa.
God bless you, dear.
What's so funny? There's no tests. There's no work. It's just day seizing.
Well, some of us are here to actually learn things.
Nerd.
Me too. It sounds educational.
Ooh. Okay.
Not a fan. In every movie, there's an authority figure that gets mad at them for making people laugh.
No, are you going to take the class?
Oh, can't. 11 was pretty much 9/11.
Oh, my God.
So your dad has your whole life planned out for you?
Jafar was a badass.
What?
Yeah. Abbott. How much does a film class cost?
$70.
You're not as understanding as Mister. You can get your hair cut off.
Oh my God!
Surely, that's the most racist thing I've ever heard.
Oh my God! What?
This is really nice of you. The memo says 4 dreams.
You guys.
She's so nice.
And how about I pound you like a right?
Why don't you all just leave him alone with his cute little baby sneeze?
You're not my mother.
Fucking Chevy Chase, man. Oh my God.
My name is Shirley Bennett.
They all enrolled.
If you can tell me why you were here at Greendale.
Why are you here?
Because I wasted 15 years of my life on a man who left me with nothing but stretch marks and a foggy memory of 2 bland orgasms, and now it's time to get what's mine.
Only when we stop stopping our lives can we begin to start starting them.
Why did the pretty young girl die?
Oh my.
Alone, surrounded by sweater-wearing cats who are trained to use human toilets.
Everyone, stand on your desks.
It's so crazy. Did anybody else have a professor like this, or just me?
You know, I was really moved by your honesty earlier, particularly the part about your husband not being alone.
But every year, there's always one cocky opportunist who's just here to coast, grab an easy A.
That would be seizing the day, right?
His name's Pierce. I can talk to him. It's actually you, Mr. Winger. Until I met you, I...
Wouldn't him taking that class be seizing the day because it's an opportunity?
Well, I'm glad to hear it, because if you don't genuinely seize the day, before the end of the week, then you will be seizing an F for the semester.
Our first assignment is a documentary. They're like real movies, but with ugly people. I'm learning a lot.
That is so wonderful.
Back in the day with the camcorders.
Actually, I'm doing a movie about my dad.
That is brilliant. How did he react to you signing up for the film class?
The part hasn't happened yet.
Oh, shit.
Involved in my family's business?
Holy war.
Where do I find Mr. Bitter?
That's right. I'm a woman with rights, and you can see my whole face.
Oh.
What the fuck?
But I'm getting a major B-word vibe from you.
Wow, I can't believe I missed out on getting involved in this.
This between
us!
Don't touch me!
The precursor to the phone.
Abed is an adult and a U.S. citizen.
What the? What does that have to do with anything?
Jeff, I think you should play the role of my father.
He doesn't even give a shit.
You already know your line.
Wait, is that the second time that they said that? I don't want to be your father, and he responded? Or am I going crazy?
Are you dressed like an 80s rapist?
Professor Whitman comes by here every morning.
Dude, they really pushed the line in this.
It's amazing what you're doing for Abed. I mean, a lot of people talk a good game, but you follow through. Love you.
Bet that doesn't happen to you a lot.
Happened yesterday. Shirley's just doing her homework.
Hillary, thank you for getting people coffee. I love you.
She is a genius.
How's it going, buddy?
Good. My film is coming together.
Damn, you got a new camera.
Are you wearing that because you're playing the role of my dad? Oh, come on. I got you.
No, really, I don't need it.
Oh my God!
Sell to me. Look at all this cash.
Hey, I will.
What?
I see men in your situation, Troy. No, those are both. First, I lose the jacket. You look like a high school bitch. More importantly, it's your sneeze.
He does. You got to stop wearing the high school letter jacket when you're in college.
You know, like the explosive shock the room and the silent sneeze. The draw them in, sneeze, you know. Maybe I wouldn't sneeze. You could even use a sneeze to drive home a point. Like, I think the Cubs are going to win all this year.
Tell me more.
Oh, you shared. Dude, he makes the creepiest faces.
Good morning, Greendale. Bring it in here. Nice. Thank you so much, you guys. That was really fun.
Sloppy. And considering the age of these girls, unwittingly creepy.
I was actually thinking that exact same thing.
Or you won't just fail my class. You'll fail life.
I feel like Patton Oswalt would have been a great actor to play this character.
Thank you.
Is he gonna kill us?
He's learning new tricks and tips.
Yeah,
I wonder, where did he get all that money from?
Or a family dinner.
It's a study group and a pizza. Let's not get carried away. It's not the two of you that need to talk.
Hey, wait a minute. Where's Weezer?
They're coming.
You and your pillow-lipped girlfriend got all up in my stuff because you wanted to be cowboys, and then you turned chicken when you found out it would take more than speeches and guided missiles. I'm talking about your speeches and her guided missiles.
Oh, my God.
The point is, Greta is sorry.
I'm finished. Britta, Jeff, Dad.
Is he using iMovie just like I use iMovie? What the hell?
I think you are weird, Abed.
Why will you not answer me?
This is so creepy. Was there a horse?
And I think the wrong person just left.
Oh my God.
It's not exactly
exactly Citizen Kane.
I love when parts hit home in a comedy. Like, he's a good father.
With falafel as a fallback.
Did you do all of that to me on purpose? But that's not a very nice way to treat
you. He's a good director.
God bless you.
Thank you.
You should kiss me.
Oh, no. No. I'm so upset.
Day seized.
We're even.
Oh. Woo. Thank goodness. Oh, man. Almost had me for a second. My heart, like, stopped.
Am I crumping?
No.
Am I crumping?
No.
Am I crumping?
No.
No. This is crumping.
They're like the best of friends.
We're crumping.
No, you're not.
Holy shit. All right, another really good episode. That was, in my mind, an Abed episode. I didn't see that coming. Like, for a show that's a comedy, and this is how I feel about all comedies, because some comedies are just comedies. They're just funny. Not much serious happens, but I was really surprised behind the reasoning why Abed wanted to do film. I don't know if it was particularly because he figured it was a way for him to express himself. I could see that. But I think that it was just a specific, he wanted to get a point across to his father, maybe. But that was a really heartfelt moment. And I almost cried, to be honest. But yeah, I like Abed. He's one of my favorite characters. I'm growing into him. It was really funny. Starting from the end, going back to the beginning, the professor, it's crazy because I'm 42. So when I was in college, that was like 20 years ago, probably. Yeah, it was 20 years ago. A little bit more, like 1998. And I did have a professor that was just like that guy. He didn't make us stand on the desks or anything, but I remember his classes were really easy. Tests were really easy. I remember the first day of class, he sat us all down and he told us, remember where you sit, because if you don't sit in that seat every class, you'll probably fail. And I didn't know why, because, like, you know, you take the first test and it wasn't particularly hard, but you realize every seat corresponded to, like, a color, and he gave you the answers to every test. But if you didn't sit in your seat, you'd have the answers to the wrong test. And then I remember at the end of the semester, everybody had, like, A's or A pluses. And back then, if you were averaging an A, you were exempt from the final. And I remember he told us all, he's like, we're all exempt from the final, but we all have to take the final. And we were confused. Like, we were kind of pissed off that we had to go in. And we all went in, and he called everybody up by name to his desk. And he was sitting there. He'd say, Steve Santiani, that's me. Walk up. He had a piece of wood. It was about the size of a piece of paper. And inscribed on it, it said, the final. And he said, take the final. So you took the wooden piece, and he was like, okay, now give the final back. Give it back, he let you go. So this really reminded me of that. Sorry for that tangent. But this was a funny episode. Yvette Nicole Brown, hilarious. I love how they kind of subvert expectations where you kind of forget that she's doing the assignment when she's telling Jeff and the barista that she loves them. That was pretty witty and pretty funny. Again, Jeff wasn't as douchey this episode. It was creepy with those girls. Like, that was the first thing I thought of. That was really weird. And then he paid them off, I think. Creepy dude. But the end almost broke my heart because, and I fell for it three episodes in a row. She's done it. Britta's done it three episodes in a row where at the end of an episode, you think she's finally like fallen for him, but it's a trick. So when she told Jeff to kiss her, I was like, you gotta be shitting me right now. But I was very happy that she only did that so he can pass the class. Like, she doesn't hate him anymore. She's helping him because she helped her. And that was it. So I'm hoping for now that that is it. I really don't want them to fall in love. I like them better as eventually being friends and doing, you know, relationship stuff on their own. But yeah, and obviously Chevy Chase, again, hilarious. The whole sneezing conversation was funny because everyone does that sneeze, not purposefully, but you know, when you feel like you have a huge one and then all of a sudden it goes away. So that was pretty funny. All in all, like you guys have told me, 1, 2, and 3, each episode has definitely gotten better for me. And I was very happy with this episode. So let me know what you thought of my comments. Let me know what you guys thought of episode 3. And then just tell me, without spoiling anything, what am I looking forward to in the rest of the season? I'm sure it gets a lot better, but I really did like episode 3. So let me know in the comments below. And please, please, please keep liking, subscribing. Hit the notification bell. I finally got my ID. I'm at Screen Sanctum, so it's easier to find me. And if you're on Twitter, if you're on Instagram, also come check me out there at Screen Sanctum. And I'll see you on the next video. Peace, guys.